Refracted light, rotating shadows, fluttering color, all carefully choreographed to a piece of music. Mary Ellen Bute was one of the filmmakers in the early 20th century in pursuit of visual music, a type of film where the images contain the abstract emotional quality of instrumental music. Most often, these films presented non-figurative shapes choreographed to a classical composition. Mary Ellen Bute made around a dozen such films between 1933 and 1953. Originally from Houston, Texas, Bute studied painting at the Pennsylvania Academy of Fine Arts. As a young student, she attempted to capture musical forms through visual means, but found that painting was inadequate to the task. She recalls of that time, painting was not flexible enough and too confined within its frame. She experimented with different media, including a color organ, before ultimately finding her way to cinema. The short films directed by Bute bear some visual similarities to other abstract filmmakers in the 1920s and 30s. However, Bute's inventiveness and interest in technical innovation helped push her images toward increasing complexity and expressiveness. In Synchromy No. 2, for example, she utilizes prisms in a particularly novel way, creating these blossoming light abstractions to complement the flower imagery elsewhere in the film. Light, form, movement, sound. Bute asserted that these were the core elements of what she called the absolute film. For her, the absolute film addresses the eye and the ear. Other motion pictures, although making use of the sensations of sight and sound, address not the eye and the ear, but the intellect. In other words, absolute film is visual music. Bute was a technical filmmaker, and she was just as apt to collaborate with mathematicians and engineers as she was with other artists. For her film Abstronic, she teamed up with a scientist who worked at Bell Telephone Laboratories to create an oscilloscope that Bute could play like a musical instrument. She describes it saying, "By turning knobs and switches on a control board, I can draw with a beam of light with as much freedom as with a brush." Of course, Bute's images are designed to complement particular pieces of music. One of the strengths of her films, as examples of visual music, is that they avoid simple, sing-songy repetitions of the soundtrack. While there certainly is a rhythmic relationship between song and image, the visuals also contain surprises, counterpoints, and inventive interpretations of emotional tones evoked by the music. They are synesthetic without being redundant. I'm Laura Ivins. Thank you for watching.